So what kind of flu did you start on, and how old were you?
Well, I was sort of about 9. I stopped playing the violin because my violin was home sweet home for about 3 million Irish woodworms, and they were chomping away at the violin as I was playing. Every time I turned it upside down, all the dust would fall out. Anyway, I gave that up and took up the flute because my dad played the flute, my granddad played the flute, my uncle Joe played the flute, and he studied with my grandfather and I studied. Because I wasn't talking to my dad at the time, I was 9. I thought I was 19.
And what kind of flute was it?
What flute?
Your first flute.
Oh, I don't know even the kind of name. It was like a 5. But it was about this size. Like a piccolo in B flat. Or A even. And it had 5 keys. And of course, we never played with complicated keys. Everything we played was on key of D or G or something like that, or C minor.
And how old were you when you got your first flute like this?
Oh, I think I was about maybe 16. My dad bought a flute from some guy. I don't worry about the money for it. For a
So James was brought up in Ireland, I don't know if you know that, in Northern Ireland. And they didn't have much money, right? To put it mildly.
Yep.
But
a lot of cash going around.
No, but you had a good time. You had a very good teacher, right? Billy Dunwoody. And you used to always play in flute bands when you were young?
Yes. The flute bands that we played in, we had arrangements of Motown symphonies and things like this. I mean, the first time I ever heard the Jupiter Symphony was played by a flute band. And then I heard it played with an orchestra, and I thought, man, the intonation's horrible.
And you still like conducting the flute bands and things like that, right?
Well, I do it.
Yeah, and well, but you like working with everyone here, and
of
we're
going to
do some nice